Good morning, Larry here with CanhamTrailers.com, and today our video is all about J-Rail. We're going to be installing J-Rail on the 59 Shasta. It's got all the skin on it, it's buttoned up, and it's ready to go. So we have to start with the awning rail first. That's where you always want to start, unless you don't have any awning rail. But it's still a good place to start. The awning rail, of course, goes on the curbside of the trailer. It'll go from about here to the same level spot on the other end of the trailer. You're going to need help with this. This is where you need a second person. So with that, we'll go ahead and get started with the awning and J-Rail. Took the J-Rail off a long time ago when we started this project. And now we've cleaned it up. We've stripped all the paint off using Jasco paint stripper, which you can get at Home Depot. Really expensive stuff, so be careful with it. Follow the directions and wear gloves. And then we gave it an acid bath. You know how to do that. You should by now. If you don't, go look at the other polishing videos that I have, window polishing and so forth. And now it's dry. We've washed it off with water, and we're ready to put it up. This awning rail and the J-Rail will all get painted when the trailer gets painted. So we're not going to polish it. Alrighty, so we're going to first thing we're going to do before we apply tape is we're going to pick this rail up. We're going to put it up to the point where it goes on the trailer. And that way, when the tape is on it, the other person helping you won't accidentally stick it to the trailer in the wrong spot and then pull it off. Because that would pull the tape off. And once the tape starts coming off, it'll all drop to the ground and then your tape's no good because it's all dirty. So we want to do a dry run first. Then we'll go put the putty tape on, and we'll come back out here and we'll put some screws in it to hold it up, and then we'll just put all the rest of the screws in. So here we go. Alrighty, so this is just the dry run. And what'll happen is I'll position it where it's supposed to be over here, and that should automatically make the other end go where it's supposed to be. You want the reveal, go ahead and hold it up. It's a little curved, curves a little bit different because of the time that's gone by. Okay, I see where it needs to be over here. So it's about where I thought it was, really.
Right at the top of the brow.
Yeah, let's see where yours is. It's about
right on the top of this design here.
That's where I thought it would be, right where the wing is. Yeah, okay, right, so the back end of the top on this one is going to be right where the wing is. And on the front, it'll be just below the brow for this window. So I can see where it is. I'm going to actually make a mark here. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to start by putting a screw in here and then bend everything as we go to even it out with him holding the other end. We're going to put three screws in this without putty tape to get it started. Then we'll take it down and apply the putty tape. So Bill, why don't you just hang on to it for right now? Keep your arms spread like this so that you don't bend it. Just stand there and try to look stupid for a bit. And I'll go get the screw gun.
It's so hard.
Is he looking dumb yet? Looking stupid.
You're looking stupid.
Alright, here we go. Try not to scratch the trailer all up. Important thing is to make sure you got a bit that holds that screw tight. Because some of the bits and some of the screw heads don't match up too well. And you don't want to be putting holes in your trailer. So I'm going to start with it here to get it about where it needs to be. I think I've got it right here for the first screw. And remember, you want the lip of this to stay down about an eighth of an inch. About an eighth of an inch away from the end of the trailer. Nice to start with a fresh battery too. Bill, just stand there and look stupid, and I'll be right back. Now you don't have to screw it all the way in, just enough to hold it. There we go. Okay, now Bill, hold it up higher. Higher than it's supposed to go. All right, right. A little higher. Right about there. Hold it right there. And what you're doing is you're moving it around so you can find where you want it to be. And then you're going to bend it down a little bit. See? All right, now we're going to take the whole thing and bend it down like this. Not the easiest thing to do, because this stuff is pretty stiff. You go ahead and bring it down some. Follow me. There we go. The J-rail is much easier than this stuff. Right there. You want to do this before you put the tape on so you're not messing with the putty tape. Right there. See, I'm keeping the top edge of the lip an eighth of an inch below the top of the trailer. Okay, now up some. I want the bend to be here, not in the middle, so let me do the bending. All right. A little higher. There. Got it. This one's going to take a few more screws than usual. Somehow over time it kind of lost its shape. Okay, down. About there, and at this point it looks like it's going to follow the curve of the trailer pretty good. So where it's actually following the curve of the trailer on its own, you don't really have to do any screws. You want to go down to where it stops following the curve of the trailer,
right about there.
And that's where you're going to be doing some bending, so you want to put a screw in it.
Yeah, it does look good.
Yeah, it will be. So, right about, if you can get out of the way, right about here, close to me. Actually, at that point, we're pretty good. I'm going to trade places with you, Bill.
Right.
You can just kind of get over here, stand there and look stupid for a bit. One more little bend ought to do it. That goes below where the wing is. Just a bit. And I didn't really want it to go below the wing, so where the wing is.
I guess you notch the wing.
No, you don't notch the wing. So it's a little high here, just a bit. These are the things that you have to predetermine, and that's why we're doing this dry run. We get these problems out of the way early. So I'm just wondering if I should drop the front a little bit more to get it out of the way, or if I should just cut the awning rail. I'm thinking I'll probably cut the awning rail. So I'm going to get a pin and mark it. because I like where everything else is already. All right, so you can see here where our wing goes, and actually where the awning rail is sitting now matches it just fine, except it's sticking up here. We can't have that. So it's going to come down here like this, and I'm going to mark the wing as being right there. Okay, Bill brought up an interesting point, and again, this is why the dry run. He's talking about maybe bringing it all the way down to here, which is about the same distance that I need to cut off on the other end. And actually, if you look right here, it kind of looks like that might be where it went to. It's hard to say. Before you pull this off, it might be a good idea on your project, when you start the trailer, to make marks and take measurements, take pictures, and see where it went to. So we're going to do that. We're going to undo all these screws, and we're going to start it down here and see what happens. And if that works out okay, then again, that's why we do the dry run. So let's try that. Let's go down to there. How does that work, Bill? Does it look better?
Hold it up. Lines up. Lines right up with that.
Okay.
The wing.
All right, then we'll start here. So there you go. Bill had a great idea. Get the screw started.
I got this if you want to let go.
Oh, there went the screw. Oh well. It's just kind of hard to hold it and screw it at the same time, but I got it. Raise the whole thing up, right there. Hold it right there. Yeah, this actually follows the radius a little better.
Yeah, it does.
Get it all up just a little bit more, right there. Right there, I like it. Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
Hold the whole thing up.
Huh?
Hold the whole thing up, even more. Hold the whole thing up higher. There. Okay, so we're gonna do a little more bending here. Now we're just gonna do the same thing we did before. We're just gonna bring it around and to the curve the best we can here. And actually, I think that was the only bend we had to make. So the rest of it's looking good. So now we're gonna go put the putty tape on. Apply it to the other side, and then we'll bring it back and we'll set this thing in. Thanks, Bill, for coming up with a great idea.
You bet.
Okay, you want to support that?
I got it.
Okay. I got it. Oh, there you got it. I now use 1/8 inch thick by 1 inch wide putty tape exclusively on everything, because a 3/4 inch in a lot of places, it leaves little voids along the top or the bottom, and I don't like that. So I now use 1 inch tape exclusively, and the excess you can save if you want for brows or whatever, but it's not enough money to cause me any alarm because the extra money, because you know these are about 10 bucks a roll, and I don't care about the couple extra bucks because it's going to save my trailer from leaking, my trailer that's going to be worth, you know, $18,000-$20,000 when it's done. So I don't care about a couple of bucks saving it. So that's what I use from now on, and we're just going to go ahead and apply it like normal. You've seen me apply putty tape before, but here you can watch again. Matter of fact, I'll even hand the camera to Bill. Alrighty, so you've seen me do this before. We want the putty tape to be just a little bit above the top here, because that's where most of the rain comes from. We'll spread some of this out Alright. We'll start applying the putty tape. Do this mostly by feel. I can feel that the putty is just a little bit above there. You're mainly worried about the lip that you're covering, the fold over of the metal, and the screws, but you don't want any water getting in through the top. Okay, so we get it on there, run it around the curve, around the radius. Look at all the gnats. I hate these bugs, they drive me crazy. And you want to press it on there, not too hard, you want to leave some thickness there. Get it going. Now, when you're pulling this away from the roll, you notice I'm pulling it like almost straight back. That's to keep it from stretching. You don't want it to stretch. So be careful when you're doing that. And we'll just keep doing this all the way around. There, see what happens when you pull it too fast? It stretches. You don't want to do that. You want to keep the paper intact on it. It makes it harder to apply. You have to tear the paper is what you have to do. Because it's stretched and now it's longer than the paper. That it's all good and set on there so it doesn't fall off. All right, and what we will do, because I'm going to be putting my screws in first, we'll start at this end. Come here, bring the camera. What we will do is start the peeling of the paper and only go back. And remember what I told you in the beginning, or not in the beginning of this tape, but others where you saw putty tape being applied. Always hold it down to itself and pull straight back. If you pull it up, it'll pull the tape away from the project. So we start like this, and then once we get a few screws in it, we'll keep pulling it back as we go. Trip.
Yeah, see you next fall.
All right. Get that screw started in its hole. You'll raise the whole thing just a bit. Tighten it all the way yet. Yeah, I'm pulling that. This makes it pretty easy. Two people. A little higher. Right there. Now we're going to start bringing it down. And you don't want him to be the one that's pulling all the weight on it. You want to be holding it here. Because otherwise you'll bend it in the middle. I'm just going to bring it to where it needs to be. Put a screw in. Here. just a bit? Right there, perfect. So you can even use the paper as a guide, because it sticks up beyond the putty tape a little bit. Working out really well. Right there. Oops. Out a little bit. And I can get it a little bit more. Bend it out this way a little bit. Too much pressure on it. A little more. Now I'm going to have to just undo this screw. Okay. Down a little bit. More. Right there. That screw's no good. Some of these screws, the heads are just no good in them. Chinese stuff. Up just a bit. And now, Bill, you can actually just go ahead and get out of the way. Just stand there and look stupid for a while. Apparently, they can see. Show the reveal. You want to try and keep it, you know, an eighth of an inch below the trailer top. It's hard to get screws out of the pocket now. Really working out well. Glad I listened to you. You just followed the curve perfect all by itself. That's great. I thought we were doing a little bit too much bending. Now watch as I tighten these. Before I add all the other screws, I'm going to add all the other screws, but I don't need to waste film with that. But this is what you want to accomplish. See how it splooged it out here? And when it starts slipping on the head of the screw, that's when it's time to stop. So as I put in each screw, fill in the spaces, I'll tighten them down to where they splooge out about that much. Here, now we can actually set this thing on there. See
what it does? It's perfect.
Pretty much perfect, just like that. See? Yeah. So there you go. Now what I'm using are number 8 steel screws by 3/4 inch. That works best for J-rail and awning rail. And the awning rail here, oh man, a lot of screws. Look at all the screws, jeez. They're about an inch and a half apart. And then of course what I do is, when I, as I'm going along, before the trailer heats up too much, because it's easier to do when it's cool, is I just run my knife along here like that and pull up the excess putty tape. See, just like that. cleans it up real nice. Then underneath it's the same thing. I hold it in at an angle so I can get it all. Just run the knife along up until where you stop screwing. And get that excess out of there. And we continue screwing, dropping. Screwy like that. That's going to screw the other way. Oh. I'll have to put toothpicks in there. Take some toothpicks. Fill that hole going that way, and the other one going that way. Let's see if we can get the screw to go in straight now. There could be a staple in the way. I'm surprised I haven't hit one yet until now. That was 100 screws because that was a brand new box that I opened up. So this is the one piece of rail. Look at all the screws. One piece of rail uses more than 100 screws. Okay, let's see if this will work now. There we go. So that worked good. And, this guy's there tight. I'm going to tighten this one down before I get there. Yeah, I think I hit a staple with that. Two to go. So that's why I had to do what I did. There, and then that looked nice. Now we'll get underneath again. There we go. So the awning rail is installed, ready for awning. It looks beautiful. So make sure, go detail it. Make sure you don't have any little pieces of putty tape hanging out here and there. And now we can move on. Now that we have this installed, we can move on to the J-rail, which goes from here all the way down, and same in the back, except we don't put it where the wing is on this one because the wings are flush. Some of them come with spacers. The wings come with spacers, so you don't cut out the J-rail. You put the spacers on, and it's held away from the trailer, over the J-rail. usually what happens is, I believe anyway, because there's not too many people that used to work there that are still alive. Usually I think what happens is, if you got a Shasta without wings, because some people order them without wings, and or what they did back in the day, and then somebody else bought the trailer and wanted the wings, so they ordered wings and put them on with spacers. But the ones that came from the factory without wings had constant J-rails, so you're going around with no gaps. The ones that came from the factory with wings, they gapped it for the wing and put it flush on the trailer. At least that's what I think happened. Okay. Yeah, and that's what's left. Now you can save that. I do save it. I use it. I stick it in things. I kind of save it. You know.
Does it help to put it in a plastic bag or anything?
Yeah, you can put it in the refrigerator. But I just leave it out here. Stuck to the top of one of these posts. See, like there? I don't know how long that one's been sitting there. Good morning. Larry here with CanHamTrailers.com, and today we are going to do J-rail. We're going to apply the J-rail and the awning rail to the 1959 Shasta. So, all right, hit the button. Take two. Don't look stupid. Cut. Take three.
Stop it.